the Sunday Colour Supplement on Radio Redhill. Radio
Redhill. And it's time to talk about magic with two exponents of the art who are with Nigel Gray.
In the studio now with me, I'm delighted to say we have Pip and Paul, and fortunately they're a bit like Ant and Dec, and Pip is on my left and Paul is on my right, so I can work out which is which. So a very good afternoon to you both.
And to you.
Good afternoon.
Now, Pip and Paul may not be known to everybody, but they are well known to people apparently in Spain and all over Europe. So tell me why and what you do.
Oh, well, we were invited out last year, around this sort of time actually, to record a TV series. And it was 6 episodes, half an hour each, which meant quite a lot of magic had to be created for that event.
We should explain, we are magicians.
We are indeed, yes. The shows that we do are family-friendly magic shows.
Exactly. We met at the Magic Circle. We formed a double act very soon afterwards, and we've been going from strength to strength ever since. So, yeah, the European connection, we were flown out this time last year. We recorded 6 half-hour episodes. They went out over Christmas. And, yeah, so that's how you may have heard of us.
Providing you've been to Spain or somewhere in Europe.
Well, it did show in England, but it just wasn't advertised in England, I don't think.
Okay, But you have done shows, of course, all over the UK, I assume, because you are based in the UK.
That's correct, yeah. In fact, we've even headlined at the Magic Circle.
Have you?
Oh, yeah. Very proud of that.
Yeah, we were asked to perform as Pip and Paul at the Magic Circle and had some great feedback, really good audience. And this was for one of their public shows. So all the actual, not magicians, they're for public shows that come in to see magic. And they felt we were good enough quality to put us on as the headliner, which is
excellent.
Wonderful.
Now, radio and magic don't necessarily go together, but have you got any trick, a bit later on when in our chat, have you got any trick that works on the radio you could think about for us?
Yeah, we can think of something, I think.
Okay, we'll come to that in a few minutes then. Okay. Now, the reason you're here particularly now is that you've got a show coming up at the Barn Theatre in Oxted. Do either of you have any connections with Oxted, or is it just random?
I'm Paul. Yes, I do. My wife comes from Oxted, and her family have been very heavily involved in the Barn Theatre there for years, generations. So when I married her, I married into that, and I've been performing at the Barn Theatre in various guises, directing shows and being in shows for probably 20 years.
20 years.
Yeah, I think so. If you haven't been there, it's a beautiful theatre, very, very welcoming. A really good standard of amateur theatre goes on there. But they also put on fundraising events where they have copycat, so the Rolling Clones go there, things like that. Very varied. Very varied shows go there, and they asked us to appear sort of to keep up their variety of shows, I guess.
And keep the standard up, obviously, yes.
Yeah, absolutely right.
Of course.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely.
They must have... We've done some other shows nearby, so there's a theatre in Hawley called the Archway Theatre.
Yes.
We were there last year, and I think word got to the Oxted Barn that it went well, so they've asked us to go there, which is lovely.
And
so we're there on the 27th. Yeah. Of this month, which is on a Friday, and there are still a few tickets left, I believe.
Just about, yes.
Yeah, so those who are interested in getting tickets, they can be purchased from our website, which is pipandpaul.com.
Perhaps we can repeat that later on as well.
Of course.
Thank you.
Yes, that would be nice. So, that's 27th of October.
Yep, Friday evening, and it's a family show, so it's the sort of show that you can bring children to. It's designed for adults that children will love.
Oh, and hopefully we're bringing some highbrow entertainment into this as well. Maybe a little bit of Shakespeare.
I'm not sure we're going to have time for the Shakespeare.
But we have, there's a lot of budget there for lasers, for confetti cannons. We're going to have some dancing girls.
Yeah, I'm hoping that will be happening. It's
Pip, why have you got your phone out? You're not ordering them now, are you?
No, I'm not ordering them now. Honest, I'm just telling my mum I'm okay.
Okay. She worries, doesn't she?
She does.
Pip's yes. Mum, she does worry.
Yes.
She's just asked me if I've got clean underwear on. Hang on, let me just say yes. Okay, I'm done.
Sure?
Yeah, no, I'm done. Yeah.
Good. Now, 27th of October then. So it's magic with comedy, I assume, judging by that last, conversation there. Yes?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, we hope good. To make you go to laugh and then go wow and then laugh again and then go wow again.
Sorry, my mum's just said, can I say hello to you, Nigel?
yes, you can.
There you go. I said hello. There we go.
Okay. That's wonderful. Now, coming back to your show, though, it's also, I think, raising some money for the Barn Theatre, one of their projects?
So the Barn have, yes, it is. So the Barn have an improvement programme going on.
It's called Drip, though. I mean, it's called Drip.
It's the Dressing Room Improvement Programme. So they've done a lot of work front of house. They've got a really improved bar and reception area now. They put some air conditioning in, so the audience have been looked after for a very long time, and they realised that the poor players had a bit of a rough deal at the back. So they're building a big extension there. I think they're on phase two now, which is the toilets. So they've got some new dressing rooms. Now they've got the toilets, and I think phase three will be joining them together. It's called Drip, and the proceeds of the show goes to help that programme of work.
Okay. Now, how long have you two been working together then?
Well, we've been best friends and double act buddies for as long as I can remember.
Yeah. No, actually, it's been 3 years. I think just about coming up to 3 years.
Well,
yeah.
that's what I said. It's as long as I can remember, yeah. I've got quite a bad...
memory.
Memory, that's the word.
So we met at the Magic Circle. I joined the Magic Circle, which is a lovely place, and everyone's very friendly there. But for me, it just didn't feel comfortable. And then I bumped into Pip. We got on together. We became best friends very quickly. And then suddenly it was a complete experience up there. So I think before I met him, it was the Magic Semicircle.
Yes, you completed the circle.
He's completed the circle.
Oh,
yes.
I didn't know that. That's really nice to hear.
Yes, isn't it?
Oh.
Yeah, it's the first time anyone said anything nice about you, isn't it?
It is. Yeah. Well, apart from my mum, she's just sent me another message. She's just making sure that Paul's looking after me.
Tell her I am.
Yeah,
you've
okay.
got your Kit Kats.
All right, I'll tell her. Okay, got my Kit Kats.
Okay, now, you do magic. That's we've established that, haven't we?
Yes.
We do.
Yes, that's...
We're both professional magicians.
Okay.
And in fact, we're not just professional magicians, we're creators of award-winning magic.
That's true.
Yes?
Yeah, so together we created a double act which took Pip in two separate competitions across 2 years to become... In fact, you know the titles, you do the titles.
Yeah, so it's the UK National Children's Entertainer of the Year. I won that, and that was a competition that was held at the Blackpool Opera House, which is a 3,500-seat theatre, and it is fantastic. It's an amazing place, and I did a part of my children's act there, which was, in fact, it wasn't just my children's act. It was things from my children's act that we'd created specially for that venue and that event, because just putting a normal children's show on a stage that size is just not going to work. So it needed to be theatrical. Mm. So we sort of put our heads together and came up with this 12-minute act that won the competition.
Well done.
And that was our testing ground to see whether or not we could write and create well together. And if that was the first thing we did, and it went so exceedingly well, which is how we knew Pip and Paul would be really exciting venture for us both. So we've put a lot of time and effort into this show now. We're really, really proud of it, and we hope people can get along to see it.
And as you said, it's going to be a family show because it is suitable for children as well.
Yes. Yeah, we'd love children to come along. They will enjoy it, but adults need to be aware that it's not a show for children, it's a show for families. Mm. So it's you're not going to bring your children along and just sort of drop them off and, hope they enjoy it. we actually get more comments from adults saying... I think I enjoyed that more than the children did. We get that quite a bit.
Yeah.
Good. Excellent. Now, you promised us a magic trick on radio. I'm slightly concerned about this, but let's see how it goes.
Well, do you have sight of a clock?
Yes, I have one.
Okay.
I've got a clock in front of me.
Oh, perfect. No, Pip, you can't use that clock. It's digital. I need you to look at an actual clock face.
Oh, what, like an analogue one?
Like an analogue one.
The one each time.
Oh, there's one. Yeah, okay, there's one behind me.
So what I'm going to try and do is try and guess which number from the clock face you're thinking of.
Okay, so everyone at home or wherever you happen to be listening to this, if you're driving, it's probably best you don't stare at a clock. Yeah, just listen to the instructions and remember them for when you get home. But just look at an analogue clock face.
Fantastic. Yes. Okay.
I'm looking now.
Thank you, Nigel.
What have I got to do?
Just look at one of those numbers. Anyone, and I obviously can't tell which number you're looking at.
So it's anything between 1 and 12?
Any number between and including 1 and 12.
Any number between 1 and
12. Okay, now don't tell me which one.
No.
You got it?
Yes.
Okay, now I'm going to confuse matters a little. I'm just going to mix it up so you can't accuse me of following your eyes or anything like that. Mm. So remember that number, but look at 12. Now, I want you to spell that number round the clock face. So, for
instance, the number that you first looked at.
Yes. So if you were thinking of one, you would spell O-N-E and you'd end up on three. But I don't know which one you'd be thinking
of.
So
you're moving 1 hour per letter.
Yes.
Okay.
Starting at 12.
Starting at 12.
Yes.
Let me know when you've done that.
Yep, I'm there.
Hang on. I've done that, yes.
Okay, perfect. Now, wherever you are, look at that number and spell that number moving 1 hour each letter.
Yeah, I'm there.
Yeah, I'm there.
And the third time, let's do it a third time.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm there as well.
Yes.
Fantastic. So you're now thinking of a number and there's no way I could know that number.
So all the listeners that are thinking of that number, just think of the number you've landed on. We are going to try and pick up over the airways, coming back to us instead of going to you, what number you are thinking of.
Okay.
Are you thinking of it, Nigel?
Yes.
Okay. I think we need to do this together, just see if we both got the same here, Paul. Are you ready? So, one, two, three,
one.
Yes.
Fantastic.
Excellent.
It worked.
Yes.
And if you at home got one as well, we want to hear from you. Yeah. Leave a message on pipandpaul.com.
Or call into Radio Red Hill.
Okay, there we are then. Well done. Yes, you got it right, didn't you?
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you so much for having us.
That worked.
We look forward to seeing all your listeners at the Barn Theatre on the 27th of October.
What time?
We're starting at 7.45.
Correct.
7.45, 27th of October. Pip and Paul.
Sorry to interrupt you, but I should say, because we're expecting and hoping that some children come along as well, we're finishing before 10 o'clock. So by 10 o'clock, you should be able to leave and let the babysitters go home.
But is half term. So
perfect.
It's not. It's been planned that way.
Of course, yes. Unlike Ken Dodd, who goes on forever.
Yes.
Indeed. Lovely man.
Pip and Paul, thank you very much indeed for popping in. And I do hope the show is a big success.
Thank you.
I'm sure it will be.
Thank you for having us.
It's been lovely.
It's been lovely. And it's the first, certainly in my experience, of magic on the radio. So well done for that.
Yay!
As well.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Congratulations. Well done.
And as I said, Pip and Paul are opening at the Barn Theatre in Oxted on Friday, October the 27th. For more details and bookings, you can go to pipandpaul.com.